you make 50 to 60 videos in-house a month. So that's a lot. Can you tell me a little bit about your firm's experience with video and how you got to that point of creating 50 to 60 a month?
Yeah, it was a long road. This was something that sort of happened by accident. Back in 2015, when we were starting our firm, people were talking a lot about online video, and I had we had just started our law firm. We were founded in 2014. My first actual video I posted in, I think, late 2015. And it was kind of a joke. I mean, I tell people now, go back and look at it. Like, if you think that your videos are bad, go back and look at my first video. I use it as an instructional tool. You know, I'm standing there in front of a wall that I had painted gray in my house for some reason. And I was using a camera that was out of focus, and my clothes were all puffed up and all out of the place. And my lapel mic was, you know, the cord was like sticking way out. It was terrible, but it worked. You know, we actually put that video on YouTube, and not a ton of lawyers were doing that at the time. And we started getting clients from it. And I was like, that was pretty easy. And so for some reason it didn't click right then, but I made another video. And then in 2018, I really kind of started recognizing how powerful this medium was. For the next couple of years after 2015, we were moving offices and laying the foundation for the firm. So I wasn't super involved in marketing. We were doing a lot of paid marketing, and I was trusting a lot of the gurus, a lot of the pay-per-click people, a lot of the SEO people. We got totally just taken advantage of by a lot of these different companies, because that's what our coaches told us to do. They said, just go hire somebody to do this stuff. You're a lawyer. You should be a lawyer. You shouldn't think about your marketing. Have someone else think about it. And we made a ton of mistakes doing that. It was not the right approach. And so in 2018, I just basically fired everybody. And I said, I'm going to start taking control of our marketing, and our video marketing in particular. And so I started personally learning how to do video marketing. So I would script the videos. I would make my little whiteboards where I would write my notes, and I would record it, and I would edit it, and I would upload it and do the descriptions and do the whole thing. It was a one-man show. And when I was doing that, my volume was actually pretty good. I kind of made it a full-time, you know, I must do this. It was one of the most important things that I could do for our firm. And so I was doing about 20 videos a month. So my release schedule was one new video every weekday. And I did that for almost about a year. And then we decided to hire somebody to help me do that, to actually come in-house and start helping me produce these videos, help me script them and then edit them. So basically I was trying to systematize it so that I could only just, you know, kind of sit down in front of the camera, do the video, and then pass it off to somebody else. And so we brought in Faith, who is, you know, incredible. She does amazing work, and she helped us scale it up to 60 videos a month. And now, you know, you don't even know this, but we're putting out about 50 pieces, 25 to 50, depending on the day, every day of content. So we are now taking, you know, one big long video, splicing it up a number of different ways. And so, you know, on a monthly basis, across all of the different social media platforms, we're putting out about 200 pieces of content a month now. And our team has evolved, and we've got, you know, virtual assistants, and we've got more help, but it's a slow process. It's taken us now about, you know, kind of 2 years, 2.5 years to really build out the system.